kill you right now, Kelly. No one to see, no one to hear. Just a corpse.
Like you. I'm not the only one that knows about you and your girlfriend.
You're going to tell me who that other person is, aren't you?
You're out of your head.
No. Once you've been taught how to kill, you never quite get it out of your system.
Jeez, you're frightened the hell out of me. Anyone see you coming?
No.
Let's go before anyone gets on to us.
Rachel's got another theater. I fixed it with Lexi.
You're kidding. No, I'm not going to laugh. I'll just get the giggles off and get all the work. Why'd you have to tell me?
I'm going to bust if I don't go.
We're on in a sec.
I'm not going to laugh. It's not funny. I'm going to laugh.
I'm more sorry than I can say to end the evening like this, and I wouldn't if there were any choice. All officers are to report back on duty immediately, and the women are to be locked in their cells until the police arrive. An officer's been assaulted, and a prisoner's been found dead in her cell. She's been murdered.
Who is it?
It's Luke Kelly. Send someone up as soon as they arrive, will you?
Yes, go.
Damn the department for insisting she come back here.
Yes. And when they finish passing the buck, you know who's going to have to accept the blame.
Don't we always? Can you make sure nothing's touched till the police arrive?
Of course.
I'm just hoping they can get some fingerprints from that bottle.
Pity Andrea didn't see who attacked her.
If she had, she might have ended up like this. Women locked up?
Yes, except for a small cleaning
hotel. I said all the women, Miss Ferguson. Now, please do it.
Yes, Governor.
Oh, God. That won't do much for her paranoia.
Oh, don't worry about it. Surely even Joan will have to understand the repercussions this will have.
Do you think there was only one involved?
Oh, I don't know, Meg. Tell you the truth, we can't even assume it was the women who were responsible.
You're not thinking of
Joan. I'm just looking forward to the questions the police will be asking.
We all know she hated Kelly, but surely she wouldn't go this far.
I'm not saying she would, but the first thing Inspector Barrett will want to know is how the killer got into this cell.
Call from the gatehouse, Mrs. Reynolds. The police have just arrived.
Thanks, Pat. Better bring them up. They've got a lot of work ahead of them.
You'll be all right by yourself, Meg?
Yes.
Jeez, I mean, talk about picking the joker out of the pack, eh?
Yeah, well, I still can't believe it. It's awful.
Oh, get out. She's been asking for it for a long time.
Oh, she didn't deserve to die like that.
Well, Mum and Sean didn't either.
Well, yes, I know,
well, you're
but
always
I don't...
going on about God. Well, I reckon he's done the right thing for a change.
Yeah. Whoever wasted her deserves a medal.
Yeah! Yeah.
Shut up your noise.
Oh, I thought you'd be celebrating too, Miss Ferguson.
Have they nailed you done it yet, Miss Ferguson?
Yeah, we want to give him a medal.
Get the perishables put away.
But
don't argue. Mr. Moran is waiting to take you back to your cells. Now, hurry up. Stop
whoever done it can have my buy-up for the next 10 years.
Okay, you two.
Well, what'll happen now?
Your guess is as good as mine. I suppose the police will quiz everyone, check alibis.
And... oh, Mervyn, what a terrible thing. And while we were celebrating...
Joyce.
Come on,
oh, I'm sorry. I wouldn't feel so bad if Mrs. Reynolds would just let me out.
She's right. She's got a big day tomorrow. And I'm taking you home as soon as the police have taken our statement.
But she's going to need all the officers she can get.
Well, maybe we could help.
There's no need for that. Those rostered can handle the situation. Forget it. We have enough work without worrying about civilians.
I hope you have a wonderful day tomorrow.
Thank you for all you've done tonight.
Look, we'll never forget it, never.
That's an understatement.
Thank you.
It's a good job we all had alibis.
You won't be told again, Connors.
I'll see you in church.
Hurry it up.
That should do it.
Thanks, mate. Get a phone into the station. Tell them it's a big one. Ah, Mrs. Reynolds.
The keys. Mrs. Radcliffe's in the staff room when you're ready for her.
She's the one who was attacked?
Yes.
Can't think of a better place to start.
In the staff, perhaps. I want to get some of them home as soon as possible. They're not officially on duty.
Fair enough. Harry, check these keys. More than likely the ones used to get in here.
The women are all back in their cells. Will you want to question them all tonight?
Yeah, get it over with. Shouldn't take too long, seeing most of them are in the dining room.
Right.
So, anything that want to kill this Kelly Schiller? Any I'll hate her enough to want to get rid of her permanently.
Be quicker to tell you who didn't.
Oh, boy.
No, stay as you are. As far as I know, the police will want to see you all tonight.
What, in this stuff?
Don't be stupid, Patterson. Just get into your cell.
We've all got alibis. What do they want to waste their time with us for?
Because the whole damn lot of you are under suspicion. That's why. Now move it.
He's got in a very good mood, is he?
Yeah. Look, you'd think the screws would be as stoked as us.
Who do you reckon it was?
Oh, I don't know.
Then I know who they'll try and pin it on.
Who?
Lurch, of course.
Lurch was in and out of the kitchen all night. The screws know that.
Oh, look, I'm not saying she did it, but I bet she cops the blame.
Why?
Got the biggest motive.
Get Kelly back for what she did to her mum and her brother.
Yeah, I mean, they all heard her threatening to get the bitch.
Lexi, that means they'll think you did it too.
What do you mean?
Well, you threatened to get her for what she did to Jessie.
Yeah, well, I didn't do it.
I know you didn't.
Then what are you saying? I've been with you every minute since we left this cell.
You went to the toot by yourself.
So what?
Well, so nothing. It's just that we missed our entrance. Everybody knew. Someone's bound to ask where you were.
Yeah, well, I was at the toot fighting with this stupid gear. It's not easy getting this stuff off and on, you know?
Yeah, well, just leave it on so you can explain.
You don't believe me, do you?
I do.
Bloody hell. If my own mate doesn't believe me, the cops certainly won't.
Lexi, just tell them the truth.
Yeah, sure.
I reckon I must have ate too much. Any chance for a quick trip to the Took before you lock me up?
Don't push me, Jenkins.
Look, I'm not putting it on. I've really got to go.
Man, could I see you for a moment? I don't feel well at all.
She wasn't at the party, was she?
Just get inside.
Yeah, well, if she'd kill her own kid, she wouldn't think twice about going for Kelly.
I'd worry about my own motives if I were you.
I've got nothing to hide.
You all right?
Sorry, I had to talk to you.
You're not ill?
No, I heard what happened.
About Kelly being murdered?
Yes. God, Bob, you didn't, did you?
What do you mean?
I was so scared when I heard. I mean, you said you'd take
care
of her.
Kath, it wasn't me. I threatened her to shut her up, but she was alive when I left her. Believe me.
Thank God. I mean, I kept telling myself that you wouldn't.
It's all right, I understand.
Do they know who did it yet?
No. I've got to go now. You'll be all right?
So who's top dog these days?
Rita Connors. She took over from Kelly after the riot.
That's why Kelly cut her wrists.
In a way. She tried to persuade us Connors and Jenkins had done it. Then we realised she'd done it herself to make her escape easier.
Sounds like a desperate woman. Miss Jenkins, rings a bell.
Her mother and brother were victims of the escape.
Starting to see what you mean. Anyone else with a prime motive?
Well, before the escape, Kelly laced an illegal brew with caustic soda. One of the women's in hospital as a result. She has a daughter in here.
Which one?
Patterson. Here we are.
Hmm. I'll have Connors and Jenkins, too. Looks like one of them's done the world a favour.
You'll have your work cut out. The three of them seem to have watertight alibis.
Don't they all? And there's a dead body lying around. Well, I'd better get this tidied up for you as fast as possible. Mind if I use this office?
Not at all.
And I'll kill for a coffee.
I'll see what I can do.
Until they've been questioned by the police, so that's that.
Oh, but I'm in real trouble.
I'm sorry.
Hey, you can't do that.
Hey, Lurch, you've been eating something you shouldn't have.
Be quiet. I'm sorry, Jenkins, but you're not getting out until the police are ready for you.
Oh, jeez, what am I going to do?
I don't know, but try and hit the sink, Lurch, whatever you do.
Oh, it's not funny. Oh.
Well, they're taking a long time, aren't they? Come and question us on all.
So,
Then again, I guess we're not top priority.
No, but those poor women are going to be in for a grilling tonight.
But they're all here and they couldn't have done it.
Got to take everyone's statements, though, I guess. Look, I'll go find someone. They must...
No, Steve, we should all stay here.
I think I'll put the cake in the kitchen. Maybe the girls can have some tomorrow.
All right, dear. Oh, poor Mervyn, he wanted tonight to be so special for all of us.
I know. I think everyone had a great time, even though this did mar the grand finale.
Yeah, obviously the women don't seem too worried. This Lou Kelly must have been a pretty heavy lady.
Oh, she was. She did some terrible things, but to end like this...
Sorry to keep you waiting. This is Detective Waters. He'll be taking your statements.
Shouldn't take too long.
Where's Mervyn? He hasn't...
Oh, no, he just popped into the kitchen.
Oh, sorry, here I am. Just doing a bit of clearing.
We'll get started, then.
Well, off you go, Merv. I'll let you and Joyce get home, eh?
You don't mind. Thank you very much.
Are you sure you don't want me to stay on?
No, we've got enough staff to get us through. Anyway, you've got enough to worry about.
I hope you and Meg can make it tomorrow. This investigation could take days.
Don't worry, we'll make it, even if we only go to the church.
Oh, such a dreadful business.
Stop worrying about Wentworth. Go home and have a bath or something and relax. You don't want to be a bundle of nerves tomorrow.
You're right. Even though it is the second time around, I don't think it's going to make too much difference in the morning.
Joyce, it'll be a wonderful day. Now, I've got to get back. See you tomorrow.
Hey.
Not the best of initiations for you.
It's a worry for everyone by the sound of it. Look, I can't help being worried about Reed. Is she one of the suspects? I know she and Kelly didn't get along.
She's one of many. No one got along with Kelly.
Yeah, but I can just hear Reed shooting her mouth off about being glad Kelly's dead. You know what she's like.
I wouldn't worry. She's got a good alibi for the time the murder happened.
Yeah, I guess so.
I'm sorry. I have to get back.
I'm off.
Did you give your statement to the police?
Of course. There wasn't much I could tell them, was there?
Did you find Pat Slattery?
Yes, she's gone to collect Jenkins, and Helen said she'd look after the coffee.
Oh, good. I'll take those back with me if you like.
Oh, thanks. Yes, I think they're all there.
Governor, there's something I'd like to report before I go.
Is it about Kelly's murder?
No.
Well, couldn't it wait till tomorrow?
It was suggested I take leave, remember? I think it's far too important to wait.
All right, go on.
The new prisoner, Maxwell... But reason to believe that she and Mr. Moran are more than passing acquaintances.
For heaven's sake, Miss Ferguson, this is a murder investigation. I haven't got time to listen to petty gossip.
If he has a personal relationship with a prisoner, he should have notified you.
Thank you, Miss Ferguson. I know the rules. Now, if you've got nothing else to tell me,
I'm just doing my duty. Hopefully you can find time to do the same.
Good night. Dare I ask what that was all about? Just Joan telling me how to do my job again. How many days is she taking off anyway?
Two.
Oh. But it could be bloody hours before it's my turn with the cops.
You'll just have to whistle a happy tune.
Oh, jeez, cut the jokes, will you?
Just try and hang on, Alice.
Oh!
Are you all right?
Yeah. Hey, you don't think Kelly could have got to meet Tucker before she was done in, do you?
Oh, how could she have?
I don't know.
You should tell her what you did.
Ah, she'll be right.
It sounds like she's getting scared.
Ah! Hey, listen to this, you lot! A certain big lady in prison ended up hoping and wishing that the cops would come and get her so she'd be feeling better.
One more word, Patterson, and you're in big trouble.
Oh, come on, it's only poetry.
You heard.
Hey, Mrs. Slattery, I can't wait. The longer you've got to let me out.
All right.
Oh, gee, thanks. Hey, hang on, the police.
Thank you, Mr. Ryan.
I just wish we knew more.
Oh, don't worry. I don't think our couple will get far.
No, I suppose not. Look, can we go home now, please?
Yes. And good luck for the happy day tomorrow.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
Oh, this shouldn't take long. Dan Moulton, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right.
Look, I'm just going to nip along to the staff room and collect my things, all right?
You rest.
Oh, Mervyn, for heaven's sake, I'm getting married tomorrow, not having a baby. Oh, me and my big mouth. I'm sorry, Pitt. I didn't mean to snap
at you. Look, I understand, love. You've been under a terrible strain. Now I'm taking you home.
Yeah, come on. Let's go collect your gear.
All right. Good night, Dan. Good night, Mr. Waters.
See you tomorrow.
Yes.
So, you didn't notice anything out of the ordinary?
Nothing that I could think of.
Well, look, even the most minor detail.
No, really.
Well, we'll just get this written up and you can call it a night.
I die. I feel dreadful leaving at a time like this.
We'll manage, Joyce. Don't worry about it.
We've been saying that. Now, come on, love.
Oh, you can't go anywhere. I've got something for you. Where'd you hide it, eh? Ah, thanks. I know it's a bit early, but it's also a thank you to two special friends.
Oh, Steve, that's beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you, but you make it sound like you're going away.
Oh, no, you don't get rid of me that easy. Well, not until Julie's parole's through, anyhow. Oh.
What a shame it didn't come through in time for the wedding.
Yeah, but we'll make it up some other time. We could all get together for dinner or something. We've both got a lot to thank you for.
Oh, Steve, you're going to be just as happy as Mervyn and I.
I'm sure we will.
Oh, where's Di's piece of wedding cake?
Oh, it's here somewhere. Oh, yes.
I saved a piece for you because you didn't make it to the dinner.
Thank you, that's lovely.
Here it is.
You two mind if I head off now?
Heavens, no, off you go.
Okay, see you tomorrow.
Yes, hope you make it to the reception.
I wouldn't miss it.
Good.
Night, Di.
It could be a bit crumbly. The women had a slight accident.
I hear the dinner was a great success. Mm. Until I found Kelly, of course.
Oh, yes. Dreadful business. Mervyn Pringle, what are you doing?
Oh, just a peek. It won't hurt.
Oh, why not? Oh. Oh, look, it's beautiful.
Gorgeous.
We'll put our best wedding photo in it.
Oh, Mervyn.
Not long now, Nov. No. But don't hurry home soon. We'll sleep in and miss the whole ceremony.
Oh.
Hope everything goes well tomorrow.
Oh, thanks very much,
I'll be making sure of it.
Good night.
Night.
She's in there, mate.
Yeah, not for long. I'll find a way to get her out.
What for?
Because she's getting soft. Gotta get you out, you old dag.
So you just say that, reckon she'd show you she's still the same old Ree.
Yeah. I'll find a way to spring her, mate.
You're serious, aren't you?
Yeah! You and me, grub. I'll line it up with her tomorrow.
Better go home and grease up the helicopter.
Say, you didn't get on too well lately.
Of course not. Just told you what she did to me,
all
family.
Right, I'm sorry.
Yeah, and I'm not sorry she's dead either.
You should have done it yourself, eh?
Too bloody right.
Did you?
Look, I told you, I was just going
pretended
under
pretended to go into the kitchen, but snuck up there and
look,
got
I already told you I didn't.
Yeah? Then why are you so nervous, Jenkins?
Look, I'm not. I've got the runs and I've got to go. So can you hurry up or I'll be doing it right here.
That's enough, Jenkins.
She does have a problem, Mrs. Reynolds.
Yeah.
All right, we'll be as quick as we can. Did you leave the area at all?
I need to put the banner up with Rita.
That's Rita Connors. You'll be seeing her next.
And we came straight back.
But the banner you mentioned.
Yeah. You walked us back, didn't you, Mrs. Slattery?
That's right. Actually, I helped them hang it on the security gate.
Okay.
Oh, can I go now? Oh, about bloody time!
Quite a character.
She is.
Now we'll see what Connors has to say. We still had time before Mr. Slattery arrived on the scene.
Stephen, how wonderful!
Mrs. Sims.
You're a big boy now, darling. Call me Deirdre.
Deirdre. How are you, Mr. Sims?
Fine, Steve. Nice to see you again.
You naughty you. Your mother told us you'd be joining us for dinner. I was so disappointed.
I'm sorry. I'm sure I mentioned I had to be somewhere else.
Well, her memory isn't as good as it used to be. Is it, dear?
It's time we were going. Come on.
Oh, don't tell her I told you that, will you?
Come on.
Good night, Stephen.
Night.
Good night.
So all we need to know is, did you see her leave the dining room or not? Well, it's not your statement, but Connors was quite adamant you'd be able to verify it for her. Said you made eye contact as she left.
Yes, now you've come to mention it, I do remember that.
Oh, good. What time was this exactly?
Just after the main course had been served.
Just after the main course had been served. Well, I'd be pleased to hear that's just what Connor said. Now, perhaps we should spend a few more minutes checking to see you haven't forgotten anything else.
Sure.
Oh, I don't know why I keep on inviting those boring people to dinner.
Maudie's all right.
It'd be a lot better if you got rid of Deirdre. I only put up with them because they were friends of your father.
Oh, yes, Mother, I've heard it all before.
Heather, I will not have you speak to me.
Steve,
like
that. Hi.
Oh, hi, hon.
And how was your little party with the dregs of society?
Oh, you remembered. Mrs. Sims said you're expecting me here tonight.
Oh, she's a fool. Be an angel and top that up, will you?
He hates it when you call him that.
Why don't you go to bed, darling?
Because I'm not ready, Mother dearest. Did any women try and rape you tonight, hey?
Afraid not. They're too busy being interviewed by the police. One of the women was murdered tonight.
Stephen! How can you stay in a place like that? And don't give me that nonsense about valuable research. The sooner you're out of there, the better. My God, it could have been you.
But it wasn't, Mother. Besides, I still have plenty to keep me there.
Well, I've heard quite enough. I'm going to bed.
She's going to go out of her brain when she finds out why you're really staying on.
Yeah, poor Mother. Still, she's going to have to face it sooner or later.
Well, that's about it then, Mr. Morton.
Thanks.
Mind you, if there is anything else you suddenly remember...
I'll come right back and tell you.
Thank you. We'll have a chat to Patterson if she's there.
I'll send her in. You can take her in now, Mr. Moran.
Right.
Can you wait for me in the staff room? I'd like a word with you before you go home.
Sure, look.
I can't wait now.
You do not have the pleasure. You been in the papers or what? What about Callie? Good friend of yours?
Oh, got to be kidding.
That's right. She had a go at your mother, didn't she? Fond of your mother, are you? Nice woman?
Yeah. What's that got to do with Kelly?
Well, I know what I'd do if someone did that to my mum.
I didn't touch the bitch.
I don't believe you, Patterson. How'd you get up there, eh? Slip out when no one was looking?
I didn't do it, and there's no bloody way you could do it on me.
You hated her more than anybody else in this prison. How did it feel, breaking your head open with that bottle, eh? Good, was it?
Oh, just rack off!
Patterson.
Look, I didn't leave that party. I didn't leave it once.
Just have to find out about that, won't we?
Bastards are trying to pin Kelly's murderer.
Oh, no.
Only doing his job and carrying on the way you were didn't help any either.
Well, what did you expect?
She couldn't have done it, Mr. Moran.
Tell that to Baradig, but come on, your turn.
Why does he think it's you?
Because a bloody passenger, that's why.
If your alibi checks out, you've got nothing to worry about, have you?
Oh, like hell. They didn't like it when I told them about passenger, and this is their way of getting back at me.
It's all right, Lex. I'll have to believe you when I back your alibi.
Come on, Egbert. Patterson, pull yourself together in case they want to see you again.
Oh, they'll have to, won't they? Slam the bloody handcuffs on. Bastards. I'm going to make sure I'm rotten here forever.
If I thought Rita was in any way responsible for Kelly's death, of course I would have told them I'd seen her leaving the room.
The point is, you should have told them everything when you made your first statement.
But I knew she couldn't have had time to do anything, so why point the finger at
her? It's not your job to decide what's vital evidence and what isn't.
So this incident makes me untrustworthy, does it?
See, it compromises the whole idea of you becoming prison chaplain. I have to be able to trust you, Dan.
Fair enough, but my work here would be useless unless the women feel they can trust me too. If I run to you every time I see a minor infringement of the rule book, they'll never let me anywhere near
them. Telling the truth shouldn't be a matter of which side you're on.
I'm sorry, but that's a middle-class attitude. Those women see everything in terms of us and them.
I spend most of my time trying to break down that feeling.
That's great. And I'm doing the same, but in my own way, Anne. I've got to be able to go by their rules, too. If I couldn't, I wouldn't get anywhere near the readers and the bongos of this world.
Well, if I'm so threateningly middle class and totally unable to understand these women and their problems, I don't know why you're bothering me.
Well, can we go and talk about this tonight? We'll both say things we regret. I'm sorry, I'm not running out on you. See you tomorrow at the wedding.
I'm warning you, Egbert. I'm not in the mood for any nonsense. You with me?
Yes.
What?
I said yes.
Good. Because you've got a parole hearing coming up. I don't like it when they read that a prisoner's been lying. Even when it's to protect a mate.
Lexi didn't do it.
What makes you so sure of that? You think she'd come bawling up at you and tell us she just killed someone? Not Patterson, my love. She's too sneaky.
No.
Oh, you mean she did tell you about
it? No, she didn't do it. She was with me the whole time, except when she went to the loo.
Went to the toilet, did she?
Yeah, but you already know that.
Alone?
Pardon?
Did she go alone?
Yeah, but she already told you that, didn't she?
Obviously there's a lot she hasn't told us. What time was this?
I don't know. She was only gone a couple of minutes. She wouldn't even have time to get up to solitary, honest.
I'll be the judge of that. Now, let's take it from the top again.
Don't worry, that bloody one won't get me.
Good on you, sister. Don't let the tuggies get you down.
I'm not going to, the bastard.
She sounds very upset. Wouldn't you be? She must have made a mistake.
It wouldn't be the first time the cops nailed someone because they didn't like the way they smiled.
What are you doing?
My diary. I don't know why you bother. I can remember all the appointments I've got to keep in here.
It's hard to think back to how you felt about things, isn't it?
I can remember that too. Tuesday, bloody miserable. Wednesday, Miss Ferguson winked at me in the showers.
You can read it if you like.
Well, back of that, you tell me the happy details of Kelly's sudden demise.
Lou Kelly is dead. Perhaps her screams for help went unheard as we laughed at bawdy jokes, enjoyed life, made the most of the stale air we're allowed to breathe in here. For a moment, we cheered together, wanting the best for Mervyn and his wife to be. No one was selfish. No one wanted more than her neighbour. It was a family. For a moment, I even closed my eyes, and it felt just like I was back in the early days with my family. My husband and my sons. A family. Happy, loving. And then the light went on. The truth was told. The air was cracked with us and them, the orders given, the keys were turned, the cells locked. And now we wait, each a separate person, ready to fight each other. Allegation, counter-allegation, pain and fear from each of us. Everyone alone. And for what? For all we know, Lou Kelly might be happier now than she ever was. And death, the one we call the Dark Angel, for all we know, he may have set her free.
It's pretty fancy stuff. I reckon it might be true. All that stuff about Kelly being free, I mean.
I don't know. I hope so.
That's it for tonight. Lights out soon.
Oh, beauty. How'd it go? They give you a tough time.
What happened?
It's all my fault.
What is?
I tried to make him understand. I just couldn't.
Understand what? Oh, hey, come on. Don't go chucking tears at me.
Well, you said you were going to tell him. You said you'd tell him everything.
But I did. The bastard just didn't want to listen.
Lexi, I told him you went to the toot by yourself. And he reckons that's all the evidence he needs to get you because you didn't tell him.
Oh, hell.
I feel like I've betrayed you. I thought he knew, honest. God, I'm sorry.
Don't worry about it, eh?
He's not going to question anybody else. Lex, I reckon he's going to charge you with the murder.
We'll be back in the morning to go over a few statements, but I'd say we've got enough
but
to Patterson go on already.
But simply have forgotten about that visit to the toilet.
You were firing questions pretty fast.
The only way to catch him out, Bob, and you know it. As far as I'm concerned, she's it.
Just like that, even though the forensic evidence was totally inconclusive, there were no clear prints on the bottle or the key.
Oh, she wore gloves.
I don't think you've got
Mrs.
an evidence.
Reynolds, Patterson had a motive. A hatred of Kelly for poisoning her mother. She had the opportunity. An extended visit to the toilet. She had access to the weapon, which she probably smuggled out of the dining room in her costume. Now, what more do you want? A record shows she can be violent. She's all ready to stick a knife in a Harry Bassinger when he caught her. For my money, no jury in the country's going to let her off. I'll be back in the morning to lay charges.
Oh, bugger.
Don't see what we should have to do to clean up anyway.
Yeah, I reckon them bludgers would be nothing but each should be doing it.
I'll do your share. You just take it easy, okay?
I'll be taking it easy at Blackmore for the rest of my life, the way things are going.
Hey, just answer me one thing. Did you do Kelly?
No, I didn't.
Well, stop wasting your energy. You'll need it to help us figure out who did.
Oh, like who?
Like whoever wasn't at the party. Williams wasn't there, was she?
No.
And the kid killer wasn't there?
No.
Well, that's two for a start. We've got to figure out what they were doing for kicks while we were working our butts off.
Oh,
oh. Not again.
Oh, I can't help it. Must have had a wog or something.
Oh, I think I better go and see if she's all right.
Jeez, you're a braver woman than me.
She could get awfully sick if she's dehydrated.
Yeah, that's right. I think she should go to sick bay.
God. Look, it's not a wog. There's enough belly aching around here as it is.
Oh, it's okay. It's because she ate something she shouldn't have. A doctor wanted them chocolate mousse things with laxatives.
What?
Oh, it wasn't meant for her. It was meant for the freak, but Alice...
Ah! Trust Lurch. I wish the freak had got it.
Yeah, yeah. I thought it'd keep her out of her hair for a while.
The freak. The bloody freak.
What about?
Well, who was Kelly's best friend? She could have been up there, wiped her out and back on her rounds before anyone knew about it.
Struth.
And bashed Mrs. Radcliffe and made it look like one of us.
Now, that sort of talk isn't going to help anyone.
Yeah, well, it might help me.
Mrs. Reynolds said investigations are far from complete, so don't start jumping to conclusions.
It's true they hated each other.
The staff were questioned last night. The police are quite sure Miss Ferguson had nothing to do with it.
That'd be right.
A spokesman for the company later issued a press statement in which any involvement in the fraud was strongly denied. Our political correspondent says, however, that we can expect questions on the matter to be put in the House later today. A prisoner at Wentworth Detention Centre was last night found dead in her cell. The police have not yet released the name of the victim, but it is thought that one of the inmates will be charged with her murder later today. And now the financial news. Yesterday saw a heavy...
Oh, Steve.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
Mother?
All right, there's plenty of material here for a thesis.
I'm sorry, Mother, but you have no idea what constitutes enough research.
Don't you understand? I don't like you being in that dreadful place at all. Can't you work from that?
I will leave when I have all the material I need.
Stephen, there's another reason why you're staying on, isn't there? Oh, come on, I'm not stupid.
Mother, it's none of your business.
It's so senseless to stay in such a dangerous place when it's not necessary.
It is necessary. Now leave it.
All right, when you tell me why it's so damn necessary. It's obvious you're keeping something from me.
Nonsense.
When you've nothing to hide, you're very calm, even when you're angry.
So you told me before. Many times, in fact.
Don't you think you owe it to your father to be honest with me?
Nonsense, don't bring Dad into it.
He wanted you to be a psychiatrist, a respected member...
So I will be. This work at Wentworth's contributing to that.
Can't you see you're wasting your time?
No, just shut up, will you? You don't know what you're talking about.
No, go. Jacko just told me the freak's got 2 days off.
Oh, bugger, what are we going to do?
Don't worry, we'll nail him, Lex.
Yeah, well, we won't be able to dodge the person in if we do find out, will we?
We'll just have to make sure whoever did it are going up to it by themselves.
Yeah, well, the freak won't, so if it's her, I'm lagging. I don't care what no one thinks.
We'll be right behind you, babe. The proving she might have done it won't be easy, though. Look at all the times I've tried to nail her before.
Well, maybe Steve could find out if she went up to Sonic.
Hey, yeah, you get onto him as soon as he comes in.
I can't. He's got the day off to go to the wedding. Don't worry, Lex. We can still check out Maxwell and Williams.
We already talked to Williams.
Yeah, she went off her brain because we even asked. Reckon she knew nothing about it.
I don't know how you could think someone like Kath could have anything to do with it. It's like Alice said. If she could kill her own.
Oh.
Hey, where is Lurch anyway?
Yes.
Shouldn't laugh, poor bagger.
Connors.
Brother's here to see you.
Bongo? What's he doing here this evening?
It's bad news, I'm afraid. Your Aunt Ida's had an accident. She's in hospital.
Nah, straight up. I took her in last night.
Well, what did she do?
Swallowed a nut. Wouldn't stay still long enough for him to get it out.
Oh, no.
There's worse. It was rusty. They reckon she might develop metal fatigue and die. Yeah. The doctor showed me the X-ray. You can see it sitting there like a big lifesaver.
Yeah?
She loves it.
What?
You'd love it too if you had a big lifesaver stuck inside you.
What are you up to?
Oh, it had to be a good story for him to let me in, right? Oh, it's fine.
Oh, you silly bugger. So what's all the urgency?
We've got a plan. We're going to break you out of this scum palace, right?
What are you on, little brother?
No. We're going up north. They'll never find us.
Look, hey, stupid little bastard. How long have you been shooting
up? Oh, take it easy. I only tried a couple of times.
Fool!
No, we're coming back this afternoon when you're out here, so be ready.
No, you're not.
No, we're going to bring the bike in the back of the laundry truck, and then we're going to grab you and smash you in the gate.
Stupid.
Yeah, see, I knew it. You're losing your nerves, so we've got to move you, Rick. We've got to move you.
So they'll put you in the slammer if you try that. Don't do it.
Yeah. Just be ready, eh? Just be ready.
We want your help, Kat.
And we're going to get it too, Kid Killer.
Help? With what?
Last night, we figured you've got to know something about Kelly's murder.
Well, I don't. Honestly.
Yeah? Then what were you doing while we were all at the party?
I was here by myself.
Prove it.
I can't. I was writing.
Well, did you see anything that might help?
No. I was just minding my own business. I thought that's what you all wanted.
Start thinking! You must have seen or heard something!
Well, the officer that got attacked.
Mrs. Redford.
What about her? Well, she walked past, and then a few minutes later, I thought I heard a sort of a thud. That's
that
all.
Must be when she was bashed. Why didn't you tell me that in the first place?
I didn't think of it. I went out there, but the corridor was empty.
Now, what time was this? You've got to remember.
God, I don't know.
Well, just start thinking!
I think it was just before I heard a lot of screaming and shouting coming from the party.
That must have been us doing our act.
Yeah. I could be wrong, of course.
Oh, you ain't wrong, lady. That's my alibi you're talking about. In fact, you're so right, we're going to tell her screws right now.
He's always smoked dope. I've never minded that so much.
But he's mainline and hard and fast, and he's only a bloody kid.
No, Rita, come on. Look, we'll work something out.
Yeah, but I'm buggered if I know what.
Well, what about Dan? Well, I've thought of that. I don't reckon he'll listen to Dan anymore. He reckons he's gone soft in the head, too. I'll try and sort something out.
Come on, line up and shut up.
Moran, I've got a big problem.
Maybe it's not what Jenkins has got.
I need to see Dan the man.
Talk about it later.
But it's real urgent. My auntie's dying and I need him to see her to say clear or something. Yeah, before she pops up.
I'll speak to the governor.
But I need to see him before we go outside this afternoon.
I said I would talk to Mrs. Reynolds. Now get back against the wall. Now cut down the racket, all of you. All right, where's Patterson and Egbert?
Here, Mr. Moran.
I need to speak to the governor straight away. I've got some information about Kelly's murder.
All right, but you'll have to wait till after muster now. Just get back against the wall there. Now, come on, settle down and shut up. I won't start until this line is dead straight.
No, I didn't get much sleep. I just kept going over and over the whole damn thing.
You still angry with Dan?
No. Just disappointed. Anne Reynolds. Is he? That's fine. Thanks.
Inspector Van?
Coming through now.
Before he gets here, I think you should know. The women have got it into their heads it could have been Joan.
We'll try and scotch that idea.
Of course.
She was with Pat at the time of the murder and totally in the clear. Mm-hmm. For once.
Morning.
Really?
Well, they say the early bird catches the worm, don't they? Just wanted to cross-check a couple of the statements from last night before we get started.
You've got those, haven't you, Meg?
Yes.
Good. Just a bit of paperwork, and I say you can throw away the key to Patterson's cell.
Inspector Barrett, I think I should warn you that if I suspect any prejudices operating during this case, I won't hesitate to go to your superiors.
Ah, come on, she's guilty as hell.
So you keep saying. Whether you can prove it or not is another matter.
I'll prove it, lady, if it takes a bloody month.
Exactly.
going into town. It won't be long.
Well, you can take as long as you like. None of my business, isn't that right?
I'll be back to change for the wedding if Heather still wants a lift to her friends.
Oh. Don't look at me like that, Stephen. I'll drink what I like, when I like, and where I like.
Okay. I'll mind my own business.
Governor of the prison, please.
You sure Patterson isn't pressuring you to say this?
No. Well, I mean, she pushed me into reporting it, but it's what I heard.
All right, I'll take you through to see Mrs. Reynolds.
God, the way that Patterson girl carried on. I mean, I didn't know it was important. I'd forgotten about it. Why do they treat people like that?
Patterson could face life for murder. If she's innocent, she'd want to prove it.
And I'd want to help her. But for God's sake, I mean, one minute they're at my throat because of Linda, and then it's because they want me to help them.
Takes a while to get used to the way things are run in a place like this.
I don't think so. I'm learning fast, Bob. I can either quiver in a corner or I can stand up for myself. And I'm not going to be kicked around by those bitches anymore.
Can't take on the whole damn prison yourself. There's some bloody tough women in here.
Then I'll have to get tough too.
Calf.
You can't be here all the time, Bob. And believe me, the next person who has a go at me will get a hell of a lot more than they bargained for.
I see. Well, I'm glad you finally saw fit to let me know. It's unfortunate it's been allowed to go on this long. Excuse me. Yes?
Got a minute? Something important's come up.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Ryan. I have to go now. Obviously, I need to talk to your son as soon as possible. Yes, if you would. Thank you. Goodbye. What is it?
Maxwell says she has information on the Kelly murder.
You know who did it?
No, it's just that I've remembered something that I forgot to tell the police when they talked to me before.
You better sit down and tell me about it.
There's something I want to talk to Mrs. Morris about. Do you mind if we leave you to it for a minute?
Go right ahead. Right. Go ahead, I'm listening.
That was Steve's mother on the phone. Seems she's been worried that Wentworth isn't a fit place for her son to be working. Hearing about Kelly's murder this morning confirmed her opinion.
Surely Steve's old enough to make up his own mind.
Steve has been lying his head off to us from the word go. I've just learned the real reason he came here to work.
You realise Hookie's going to expect some bread for this knob?
What?
The tyre.
Oh, yeah. We'll fix it later, eh?
Wouldn't have had to if you'd done what I told you.
I did. You saw that jump. It was spot on.
Except for the drop.
It wasn't my bloody fault. There was a rock there, was it?
A good rider would have checked the ground he was landing on.
There's nothing wrong with my ride. Besides, I can't check the bloody ground out at Wentworth, can I?
Guess not, but hell, man, you didn't have to wreck a perfectly good tyre when it was just a tryout, did you?
Well, who cares? Come on, grubby acting like an old bloody woman. The main thing is it works.
If I can fix this, maybe.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, of course you will. We're counting on you.
You could help.
Got more important things to do. Gotta get the old girl nice and shiny for Reed.
She'll be needing it tonight.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain